Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the Dome. Some of you might recognize this place, and I hope that you realize that when we're here, we're about to do some crazy stuff, usually with fire. And that's the case today. We're going to be trying an experiment that I am pretty excited about. Not too long ago, we showed you how to make a super cool bath of acetone using some dry ice, and you could freeze stuff in it, and it was not quite as cold as liquid nitrogen, but had a lot of the same results. Something interesting happened when I poured water into the super-cooled acetone. The water dispersed, but then very quickly froze into crystals, and as it sat in there for a while, it turned into a slush. I took some of that slush, lit it on fire on a brick, and it burned pretty well. I thought it was very interesting how I could touch it and simultaneously feel like my hand was freezing and on fire. I want to try making some snowballs out of that acetone ice slush and see what happens if I just light them on fire and throw them. Then while I was thinking about that, I thought maybe there are some other ways to make some fire snowballs, and I wanted to try some of those as well. So I called up my local ice rink, and I asked them if I could have some of the scraped off snow that's created when they Zamboni the ice. They were gracious enough to let me take some of that snow, so I now have a cooler full of snow and a second cooler full of some pre-packed snowballs. And the purpose of today's video is to see what kind of fluid we can pour on this snowball to get our best fireball. We'll use acetone, isopropyl alcohol, some lamp oil, and even some gasoline on these snowballs to see which gives us the best fireball. In addition to several different varieties of making the fireballs, I have a few different things I'm going to try to launch them. Of course, I'll try just throwing them like a normal snowball. I've also got this dog toy designed for tennis balls. And some of you may recognize our water balloon launcher that Grant showed you how to build some time ago. Here we've got some dry ice. Let's break some of this up, fill our container around our bowl, then pour all of our acetone in, and we should start to get a super cooled acetone bath. Even with good gloves on, this stuff gets so cold so fast. There we go. And our bucket here, it's got lots of holes drilled into it all the way around so that our acetone will easily get in, but our dry ice will stay on the outside. Go. You can see the bubbles are starting to calm down. That means our acetone is starting to get nice and cold. Now the gloves I was wearing were good for insulation, but they weren't waterproof or acetone proof at all. And so I've actually managed to squeeze a pair of the black gloves over the other gloves. So now I should have insulated hands and ones that won't hold acetone as I'm lighting it on fire. That's just the combination I want. Let's try pouring some water into this bath, let it cool down, and see if we get that same slush we got last time. Whew! Probably not even a little bit safe either, but I've got gloves on, I've got long sleeves on, I've got glasses on, I'm kind of keeping myself held away. It's fine. Of course, the water is able to get through the little holes in the plastic container, so we're just starting to get some slush surrounding all of the bucket and the dry ice and everything. But there is a lot more of it in the plastic bucket than out. When we last made some of this acetone frost mixture, it took a little while for it to really concentrate down and freeze all of the water in it. So let's just set it aside for a minute and try adding some of our fuels to our pre-made snowballs. See how that works. We're already working on acetone, so let's try making an acetone-soaked snowball. Not what I had in mind. I didn't have quite the right tool for opening the lid the way you're supposed to. The whole thing just popped right off. It should still pour out, kind of. It'll probably splash a little. All right, we've got our snowball. Let's try and pour some acetone on. It's not gonna pour very well, but yeah, that looks like it's getting absorbed nicely into the snow. That's what we want. Now for the safe part, lighting it on fire. Oh, it's really not lighting very well. Maybe we need more acetone. That's on fire. Only my gloves on fire. The snowball is not. I have successfully melted a small portion of the snowball. I don't think acetone is going to work very well, so let's move on to trying one of our other fuels. Next up, we have our 91% isopropyl alcohol. see if this works better than the acetone. Kind of have my doubts. Snowball just doesn't wick the fuel through itself enough to stay lit. It's almost like it's made of water or something. Well, acetone didn't work and alcohol didn't work. Let's try lamp oil. Nope, still nothing. Our lamp oil gets cold enough that it even solidifies. It starts to gel up a little bit. The water in our super cooled acetone is now quite cold and we've got a good slush. I'm gonna see if I can make that into a snowball, light it on fire, and chuck it. Whew. I wanna squeeze a little bit of the acetone out, but not a lot, because I think that'll just make it not light. So let's try that much. See how this works. Just went out immediately. All right, let's try it without squeezing it at all. Just get a big old scoop of acetone slush. Still not much. Just kinda goes out right away. I'm just gonna pour it out on the ground. This doesn't work as a snowball. I don't think I'd even be able to feel anything through my gloves. Well, I've got one more idea. We have the whole acetone bath. It's really cold, but it is acetone. Boy, that just does not want to light. Our other three types of fuel didn't work, so we've had to upgrade to gasoline. And I'm a little nervous about doing this because it's gasoline, but, you know, for science, I guess. I think the whole rock is gonna light on fire, whether or not the snowball does. Yep, the rock lit on fire. Our snowball. Hey, that's on fire a little bit. Oh, it breaks open, it catches on fire better. Oh yeah, now it's nicely ablaze. As is my hand, throwing. That went out, my hand stayed lit. New strategy, I'll try dipping part of the snowball in this pan of gasoline, then bringing it over here to the fire to light it. See if this works. Yep. And I lit my can of gas on fire. That's just gonna burn now. Now I know that the idea works. I got a snowball. It stayed lit all the way to when it hit the wall. I just need to have the pan of not burning gasoline farther away from my source of fire so I don't accidentally light it by holding a flaming snowball. Live and learn. There we go, snowball soaked in gasoline. Now a long ways away from our gasoline. I don't know if it stays on fire all the way across very well. I'll try one that's considerably more soaked in gasoline, which is a higher risk of lighting my hand on fire even more. I think it'll be worth it. Ah, I got farther. I think it got farther on fire. That was like on fire until it hit the wall. That's pretty good. All right, we've got our little dog toy thrower. And now I'm not as afraid of lighting my hand on fire. It might melt this, but let's try that. It hit the wall, still on fire. Fireball, success. Now, I brought this water balloon slash snowball launcher thinking that maybe I could try using it to launch some flaming snowballs. But since gasoline is the only thing that I can get to actually make these snowballs light on fire, I'm not gonna do that because I think when it launches, it will just sort of spray gasoline on fire everywhere, and that would probably include on me. That's just too dangerous for me to try right now. I will use it to just launch a snowball, and you can see how well it works, but I'm not gonna try it while it's lit on fire. Flies beautifully. There you have it, a few mixed results with our fire snowballs. The acetone, lamp oil, and isopropyl alcohol weren't flammable enough to stay lit while soaking the fireball. They would maybe light for a second and then just go out right away. Gasoline gave us pretty good results with our snowballs, but it did have a tendency to light other things on fire at the same time. So maybe not the best idea. But it did look really cool. That's the part I like. Supercooling our water in the acetone gave us a snow that was a little bit flammable, but it didn't actually stay lit very well. It would light very briefly and then just go out, and when you threw it, it wasn't on fire anymore. Definitely our best result was from soaking the snowballs in the gasoline. I really preferred using the dog toy thrower to throw those snowballs because then my hands weren't lighting on fire as much, and although my gloves did a great job of keeping me from getting burned or even uncomfortably warm, it's obviously not a very safe thing to do. All in all, this has been a fun experiment, and although it didn't work out quite as well as I was hoping, we did get some really fun results. Thanks for joining us for this video, and remember to come gear yourself up with products and merch at thekingofrandom.com. See you there. That was just a little bit. Oh yeah, it does that. Put it out with snowballs! Snowballs are not an effective method of firefighting. I think it's just gonna end up with me with hands on fire juggling snowballs. My hands are on fire.
Hey guys, thank you for your comments. So many of you have really interesting suggestions for projects and experiments, and we love testing those out for you. I also wanted to say thank you for the great feedback you're leaving for me and my team, because we're all in this together. So thank you for being on our team.